them niggas that you just watch run around on that football field, those are the real Jews according to the Bible. What? No, why are you saying it? I think you just were looking for an excuse to say it. That's what I think. What if I told you it was in the Bible? Well, but you could have said N-word. You didn't have to say that.
Right.
Let's see if the prophets of God were called that. Acts 13:1. I'm gonna read it to you right now. Don't worry about it. Acts 13:1. Read that.
This is the book of Acts, chapter 13:1. Uh-huh. Now there were in the church there was at Antioch certain prophets.
Hold on. Listen. We do how we want to do it. So we can see any
read. Certain prophets and teachers, uh-huh, as Barnabas and Simeon. Uh-huh. And there was called. And Simeon on that was called nigger.
That was called what?
Nigger.
That was called nigger. Go ahead, don't get too close now. But Acts 13:1, right there. This is the KJV. What it say right there? What's that word?
Niger.
Oh. See that? You understand how etymology works, right?
Yeah.
So that's Latin. Then it came into English, they added what? An extra G, right in the middle. Yeah, no. Nigeria is called Nigeria after that word, which means black in Latin. Okay. I'm not saying that it's derogatory. It simply means black. Proving what? That the people in the Bible, the prophets, the Israelites, are black. That's all. That's what I'm telling you. Right? Jesus Christ, give me the sign. This is not Jesus. This is your sweet Jesus. Without the horns, it's the same white boy, though, right? There you go. Look like your little nephew, because it's not in the Bible that he looks like that. There you go. So we're here to tear down the law that that's not the sweet Jesus. What color? I'm from read that. It's all right. It's all right.
This is the book of Revelation, chapter 1, verse 14. His head and his hairs were white like wool.
So his head and the texture of his hair was like wool, right?
As white as snow.
White in color. Read on.
And his eyes were the flame of fire. Uh-huh. And his feet like unto fine brass.
Like what?
Like unto fine brass.
What color is brass? Brown, correct? Copper. Ooh, there you go. Copper. A dark copper. Watch, read.
As if they were burnt in a furnace.
But then you take that brass and then you burn it. What color is it going to be?
If you burn anything, what color is it going to be?
But it's going to get darker. You put a flame to it, it's going to get darker, right or wrong? You can look up right now, get on a good old white boy, burns brass, and you see what color it is on YouTube right now. What? Of course. I see it. I want to engage with it. Whoever wants to engage. I really would prefer to talk to my people, but I talk to the white man too. I certainly do. I certainly do. Naturally. Why? I mean, are you familiar with what's happened, let's just say, just in this country in the last half a millennium? See, Obama was a horrible thing, man. I like Donald Trump, man. But listen, I'm saying it. But listen, here's what I'm telling you, right? But not just Obama. Why? I want to know why. I agree, but tell me why. Well, maybe not the worst, but why? What handouts did he give black people? Only thing he handed out to was gay people. Don't everybody want votes running for office? See, that's why Faye Jackson didn't want to indict Amber Geiger on murder. All right, but thank God. Hey, where's everybody at now? How do y'all feel about Amber Geiger being indicted on murder? Can I get a consensus out here? Who's happy about Amber Geiger is a goddamn murderer. You agree?
So are you. That's right.
manslaughter?
No, it's murder. That's why she got indicted on murder, man. She's a cold-blooded murderer.
If, listen, listen, if I went into your house and shot you, I'd be indicted on murder right now. Guaranteed. I'd be, hey, look, bail revoked. My name? Well, you can just call me Massa.
That's right.
That's my name. Massa. You ever heard that?
What's your name?
That's my name.
I'm Ann.
Nice to meet you, Ann. That's my name, Massa. Oh, that's all right. There you go. You don't have to. You know, it's a free country. Go ahead. His name is Prince.
You ain't want to call this brother a prince. Read.
1 John 5:10. And he that believeth on the Son of God hath the witness in himself.
You stream him on title? Go ahead.
He that believeth not God hath made him a liar, because he believeth not the record that God gave of his Son.
That's right. We got to believe the record that God gave of his Son. In that record, it tells us his physical description.
It's all right. It happens. It happens. But I'm gonna tell you like this. It's in the record that Jesus Christ is a black man. Okay?
That's in the record. So you have to believe that if you claim to believe in God.
You said what? Black man or Arab? Arabs are different than Israelites. You do know that, right? You know what Arab means? It means mixed. They're a mixture of Shemitic people that wandered in the desert. Those aren't the Israelites. But see, a lot of people don't know that. Everybody got jerseys on right now for universities, and I don't see people demonstrating their college education. It's ridiculous. He was an Arab. I understand, but you kind of drunk, man, so you kind of don't count.
No,
it ain't any older. You had a few cocktails. All right. Go ahead.
This is John 7:38. He that believeth on me, as the scripture have said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water.
That's why rivers of living water ain't flowing out of these people, because they don't believe in the Bible like the Bible says to believe in. They believe in some damn religion that was given to them, some form of plantation Christianity. Straight madness, lies. Hey, what's up? I'm getting blood off my hands, man. All right, God is getting ready to bring. God is getting ready to send a thermonuclear fireball into AT&T Stadium, man. He's gonna do it. He loves all the black sonars and Hispanic sonars. He certainly does. Okay. He's getting ready to destroy this whole country. No white people in my background. They gonna have to get destroyed, man. Oh, you gotta understand something. White people have a
white grandfather.
If he's my patrilineal grandfather, then that would make me the same as him, because the Lord God deals with seed lines. That's what he's dealing with. He's dealing with lineage. Who? White people have meant me nothing but harm. Are you kidding me?
I mean harm.
You certainly do. You certainly do. Well, you have a problem with it. You have a problem with it because you're denying the reality of the matter. We got to take a look. We're standing here in a stolen land right now, right away. How many indigenous people to Texas had to die in order for white people to walk around with Texas jerseys on? How many? Can you tell me? Do you know? My question is, how many people had to die in order for y'all to be able to wear Texas jerseys? No. Every state in this country. In this country. And who did it? Who's responsible? That's the question. Listen. Our country, how did it become your country? That's what I'm asking.
It's
ours. No, but how did it become yours?
It's ours.
Listen, it was my people was here before you came. Before
your
people came. My people are the Israelites, according to the Bible. According to the Bible, the tribes of Israel came over here to the Americas.
All I know is that everybody is ours.
No. But it's convenient because y'all people had to kill in order for y'all to have a right here. I'm wrong? So how did white people get America? I'm wrong. I'm being told I'm wrong. Hold on. Don't touch me. Do not touch me.
Why do you say why?
Because did white people murder millions of people in order to become Americans?
Yes.
Let's just be real here. Can the white people, I got an honest white man in the crowd, did white people not have to murder millions of people, commit genocide in order to be Americans? It's a fact. You guys stole us and forced us over here. What do you mean? Go ahead. I told you my name is Massa. Read it. Habakkuk 2:12. Woe to him
that buildeth the town with blood.
See, that's why God said, woe to him that buildeth the town with blood. This whole country of America was built up with...
Don't worry about it, y'all. Listen, no. Not going to happen. Go ahead.
See, that's what you guys said when you took this country and murdered the Native Americans. Let me have it. That's what you guys said when you went to West Africa and stole slaves. Let me have it. Go ahead.
Woe to him that buildeth a town.
Please don't touch me. You might have viral meningitis. I don't need you touching me, Reed.
Woe to him that you might have viral meningitis. Reed. Woe to him.
Oh, I live in your country? Last time I checked, this was stolen from my brothers.
Bullshit.
You hear about it? Bullshit. Y'all didn't steal it? Y'all didn't steal it, you damn devil? The blue-eyed devil, man. Don't worry about it. Y'all keep your hands on the Bible. You're nothing but a blue-eyed devil. You nothing but a blue-eyed damn... How's all you? What's going on, man?
Not that much, you.
I'm just teaching the truth of the Bible, you know. Go ahead.
Habakkuk 2:12.
I'll be friends.
Habakkuk 2:12. Woe to him that builds a town with blood.
Woe to him that builds a town with blood. This whole damn country was built on blood. All 50 states, from sea to shining sea, all the way from Florida to the tip of Washington. All right? Go ahead.
Establish a city by iniquity.
And what?
Establishes a city by iniquity.
This whole country was founded by iniquity, man. By sin. By rape, robbery, murder, extortion, slavery. Go ahead.
Who paid your ransom?
Don't worry about it.
No. How
did you get a house here?
I bought it.
How were you enabled to buy a house on a land that didn't belong to you?
Listen,
but your people stole this land in order for you to have a job. You understand that?
Your
people, man. Your people. You failed blonde, blue-eyed people. Stole this land. Come on, unity between Texas and Oklahoma, man. And white supremacy, read.
Obadiah, verse 10. For the violence against thy brother Jacob.
See, we're not just mad at white people because you guys are ugly, all right? We're mad at you for a very justifiable reason, for the violence you've committed, right? So read. You so-called blacks and Hispanics in these damn crowds, y'all better wake up, man, all right? You so-called black and Hispanic men need to start letting your testicles hang, man. Trying to act all civilized around these damn crackers, man. To hell with these damn white people, man.
That's right.
Most High God gonna destroy these
people. That's right.
Most High God getting ready to raise up the black and Hispanic man, and y'all out here acting like homeborn slaves still. Wake the hell up, man.
Right.
Most High God calling men to let their damn nuts hang.
Right.
Not good house Negroes and good house Latinos, man.
Right. All right?
Stand the hell up for once in your damn life. To hell with these crackers, man. They can get here and they can make millions of dollars off of all those black men that was running around in that goddamn field who didn't get paid a dime up off it. Some of them is not going to get drafted into the league. Some of them is not going to get multi-million dollar contracts. What they going to have, right? But then guess what, they made all these. You have seats going for God knows what in there, man. 100,000 people. You know how much damn money these crackers was able to make off this game today? You so-called Negroes and Latinos better wake the hell up. These crackers ain't your damn friends, man. Most High God getting ready to do away with these damn people, man. But you got to be worthy, man. You got to step up. Finish that.
Obadiah, verse 10, for the violence against our brother Jacob.
See, because what you've done is rape, rob, and murder, man. And y'all don't want to own up to it. You want to leave it in the past talking about, well, I get money for my job and we house you. She's talking about housing the Native American man. That's what she's talking about, man. Right? You housing them. This is their whole country, man. You're talking about housing somebody who you stole from? Least you can do is give me a free house. Nigga, what are you talking about, man? Talking about giving the so-called black man Section 8. You better damn give me some. You stole me and brought me over. The least you can do is house me, right? This is ridiculous, man. The white man is the goddamn devil that the Bible speaks of.
That's right.
The devil, man. Period. Go ahead. Yeah, well, listen, man, because I done heard enough from you, man. Go ahead.
For the violence against our brother Jacob.
Will you acknowledge the murder that your people have committed, the genocide your people have committed? Regards to the indigenous peoples of the America.
I will acknowledge
okay, some of it. Well, who did y'all only did some of it or all of it? Or
well, are you talking about the American Indians?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
You guys did it. Okay, so what about the black people y'all brought over?
Guys, I'm part Indian.
Oh, you what tribe?
My grandfather was
don't tell her.
Well, I don't know. We don't have
to
get
him.
He was adopted.
Oh, he was
adopted. Because
we don't have the paperwork, so we know. You don't know, you're not sure? Oh, well, with a DNA, you know the DNA told a German Shepherd he was a Native American? That DNA test is BS, man. That's just a way to extort people, make money, give people false hope, things of that nature. Create a oneness ideology, man. We're not about that. This brother looked like a Native American, man. Did a white man murder your people and steal this land? They sure damn did, man. He pointed at him. He said, yeah, that's dope, man. That's dope, man. See, now, I'm glad that one of our people let their nuts hang out here. I see a bunch of stepping fetches out here, man. Blacks and Latinos acting scared, man. It ain't time to be afraid. Read that.
This is Job 38:3. Gird up now thy loins like a man.
That's what time we in. We in the time of the so-called black and Hispanic man girding up their loins like a man, coming back to these laws, Ten Commandments, and faith. Read.
Gird up now thy loins like a man, for I will demand of thee, and answer thou me.
That's right. The Most High God is demanding that we step up as so-called blacks and Latinos, man. That's what time we in. Not being scared.
What?
All right, not trying to fit in, not trying to not make these crackers uncomfortable. To hell with them, man. We're going to call them crackers and the damn devil in their damn face, and that's just what it is, man. All right? Because the Most High God is calling up real men to hit these corners, man. To go in the face of adversity, to come and tell thousands of you damn people that this whole country is going to come to an end because of the sins that it was founded upon. Thus saith the Most High God. That's what's going to happen. That's what has to happen. Okay? You can't just wear these damn jerseys and not understand all the murder that had to go into and the lies and the extortion and the robbery that had to go into you being able to wear these jerseys. For there to be an AT&T stadium in the middle of Arlington, Texas. You gotta understand how many damn Native Americans had to die for that. Huh? You gotta understand how much of a damn slave driver the Jones family is, man. Let me get on Jerry Jones real quick. But Jerry Jones is the goddamn devil that the Bible says. Jerry Jones is one of the most vile, filthy animals on the face of the planet Earth. And I can't wait till the Most High God destroys his beloved monstrosity that he built in the middle of Arlington, Texas, man. I can't wait. It's a damn monstrosity,
yes, man.
It ain't nothing but that Roman Colosseum. That Roman Colosseum. That Roman Colosseum where they used to capture Israelite slaves and put us in that Roman Colosseum.
Yes, 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 to what the loudmouth says.
Right? They listen, they still want to hook them. They lost, man. Y'all still hooking them? After that jail, man, get over it, man. Getting the hell over it. But the Most High God, Jerry Jones, is one of the biggest slave owners in the damn country right now, man. That's Jerry Jones. Jerry damn Jones, the damn devil the Bible speaks of, and he makes billions. How many black people got the last name Jones? Can you tell me? Maji.
Honey, you need to take that up to the players.
Listen.
That's a bunch of baloney.
Listen, I can talk to the players. How you know I don't talk to the players?
You're just spouting off a bunch of
I got personal relationships with players, all right?